screen is visible. Okay, wait. Okay. Yes. Yes. Okay.
Click on the loading.
This time, sir. No? Now you can view my screen. Or welcome to Department of Mechanical Engineering. Our subject is CAD CAM and Automation. This subject is basically related with the design, manufacturing, and how that various processes are carried out in the industry for manufacturing as well as a design called as automation. Now this is our syllabus structure for semester 1. So we have a total 175 marks for our subject. Out of that, 100 marks will be there for theory examination. In that, in same is there and end same examination is there. Then we have a 50 marks for external practical examination and 25 marks for term work. That is nothing but assignment part is there. Now moving towards our syllabus, we will move for syllabus. What is syllabus for our subject? That we have to see. So this is our syllabus. I am just zooming out. So here examination scheme is provided for us for the information. Now as per syllabus, what are the prerequisites required? Means what knowledge we must have before going to study this subject. So that is nothing but a prerequisites. So first, engineering graphics knowledge we must have. That is nothing but what are the different types of graphic or a graphical property or geometrical properties are there, that we must know. Means line, point, then a rectangle, triangle, or what are the geometrical properties are there for each and every model, that we must know. So means we must have the thorough knowledge of the engineering graphics subject for study of the CAD CAM and automation subject. Second one, we must have the knowledge of engineering mathematics. That is nothing but we must know the matrix, then how matrix operations are performed. That is nothing but addition of matrices, multiplication of matrices, inverse of matrices. That knowledge we must have to study this subject. Next one, numerical methods and optimization, means what are the different techniques are there in NMO to resolve the problem for optimization. That methods we have to again implement here in our subject. Next, computer aided machine drawing, means drawing or machine drawing knowledge we must know or we must have for this subject. Then strength of materials, means what are the various material properties are there, just like strength, then modulus of elasticity, Young's modulus, or what are the different SOM related properties are there, or SOM related study material is there, that we have to consider for this subject. Next, manufacturing process, it is also important, means what are the different processes are carried out to manufacture a particular product. Means this manufacturing process is also important for CAD CAM and automation. Now there are course objectives are there, that is very important part of our syllabus. You can see different course objectives are there. So first objective is to apply homogeneous transformation matrix for general transformation of 2D or 3D CAD entities. Now what is mean by this? This is nothing but we must know the transformation मैट्रिक्स फॉर ज्योमेट्रिकल ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ऑफ 2D और 3D CAD एंटिटीज. नाउ व्हाट आर द 2D एंड 3D CAD एंटिटीज? फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ यू कंसीडर अ पॉइंट और लाइन, और इफ वी कंसीडर द ज्योमेट्रिक ड्रॉइंग विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द एक्स वाई कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम, देन इट विल बी 2D एंटिटी. इफ वी कंसीडर इट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स वाई जेड कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम, देन इट विल बी 3D CAD एंटिटी. ओके, नाउ वी हैव टू परफॉर्म द ज्योमेट्रिक ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन, मीन्स वेरियस ऑपरेशन वी हैव टू परफॉर्म ऑन दैट यूजिंग मैट्रिक्स ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन एंड होमोजीनियस ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन वी हैव टू परफॉर्म. What do you mean by homogeneous transformation? That will be studied in later on. Okay. Then second objective of our course is to model mathematically, analytical and synthetic curves surfaces. Means what? For example, if you want to design a car or if you want to design a particular model, for that purpose there are two methods. One is analytical method and second one is a synthetic method. Now what do you mean by analytical method? The method which involves analytical equations, just like for example, if you consider the line, it is represented by equation y is equal to mx plus c. Means a particular model, if it is represented by analytical equations, then that will be considered as an analytical curves. Means line, circle, ellipse, these hyperbola, parabola, these are comes under the analytical curves, means which are represented by a particular equations. Now we have to perform the mathematical model for that particular curves. Next one is a synthetic curves. Surfaces are there, means in our course we have to learn how the various curves and surfaces are represented by analytical equation as well as by using a synthetic method. Okay, means we have to prepare the mathematical model for different curves and surfaces. Next, to predict the performance of simple mechanical component, means in this subject we have to study again, or we have to predict the performance of simple mechanical components. What do you mean by performance? Means its working or its function, that we have to predict using simple mechanical component, or for the simple mechanical component using a FEA softwares. Just like if you consider the beam, shaft, plate and trusses using FEA, finite element analysis, we can consider it as a finite element analysis. In that there are two methods, one is a mathematical term and second one is a software treatment. Mathematical term is nothing but what? Again, we have to form the matrices or matrix operations and we have to find out the results and check the performance or predict the performance of simple mechanical components. Means here we are not going to go into deep like analysis of engine or complex component. We don't have to study in our syllabus. We just have to study if a simple beam, shaft, or plate is considered, or truss element is considered. For that purpose, if we apply the certain boundary conditions like forces, pressure, etc., then how will be that component gets performed? Means what will be the stress distribution in that component, what will be the deflection, then what will be the changes in its shape and size, that we have to predict by using the FEA analysis. Both ways, mathematical means what, numerical way, or by using a formulas we can solve that problem and predict the performance of that particular components. So here we have to see beam, shaft, plate and trusses elements. Means these four are included in our syllabus. For that we have to perform the, or we have to predict the performance for these element using mathematical equations as well as software treatment. Just like ANSYS is the software for analysis purpose, we can perform the analysis using the ANSYS software. So this is again third important objective of our syllabus. Next, to generate CNC program for appropriate manufacturing technique like turning and milling. Now we know, if we go with the conventional manufacturing methods, turning operations are performed on lathe machine and milling operations are performed on the milling machine. Now, what is our objective in this syllabus? Generate the CNC program means we have to generate the program for a CNC machine so that we can perform the turning operation and milling operation. So, by using software, we can generate the program. Also, there are methods, manual method of programming is there to generate the program. Means we have to simply prepare the program using a standard format. We have to provide that program to the CNC machine computer, and after that it will perform the various operations as per programming. So that is our objective. Next, to select and apply suitable rapid prototyping technique for engineering applications. What mean by rapid prototyping techniques? So there are certain rapid prototyping techniques are there which are used to save the time of manufacturing. Okay, 3D printing is there. So these are the methods like rapid prototyping which can be used for the engineering application. Means that part also we have to study in this syllabus. Next, to study role and component of different automation strategies. To study role and components of different automation strategies. Automation strategies manjes kay or means what? By using automation technique, we have to save the cost of manufacturing, we have to increase the productivity, we have to maintain the quality of the product. Okay, so for that purpose, robot technology is there that we have to implement in industry. Okay, so that will be the part included in our syllabus. After that, this is a course objective. So this will be there after when we learn different chapters, then automatically course outcome will come out from that. Okay, then this is our course content unit wise. So unit number one is a computer graphics. Computer graphics is nothing but what? Use of the computer system for different operations. Okay, so in that we have two points are there important. One is a transformation, 2D and 3D, and second one is a projections. So in transformations operation, in computer graphics, simply what we have to do, by using computer software we can perform the necessary changes in the graphics by using a programming or by using the database. Okay, so graphics is nothing but what? Pictorial view of any component, that is called as a graphics, which can be visualized on the screen. Okay, so using computer graphics we can perform the various transformation operations on the 2D, for 2D as well as 3D component. In that, various transformations are given. Means first there is introduction of CAD, CAM and computer graphics. Then we, what is meant by formulation. Then these are the various operations that are mentioned there. Then what is meant by homogeneous representation. What is meant by concatenated transformation, that is nothing but composite transformation. Then mapping of geometric models, inverse transformation, then 3D transformations. That will be the first unit content. Okay, so here we must have the thorough knowledge of a matrix multiplication. Means we have to first form the models or matrix for a particular model with respect to its coordinates. Means what? If we consider a point, it has a only point in a two dimensional system or point in a three dimensional system. If we consider a point as an entity in XY coordinate system, then it will be considered as a 2D coordinate system. Okay, and in that, a particular point is located with the coordinate, for example, X1 and Y1. So similarly, if a line is there, then line is formed by what? Two points, end points. One is P1 and second one is a P2. So how that line is represented? By using a matrix. Means we have to form the matrix for that particular geometric entity, and after that we have to perform the certain operations on that line. Means what? That line, we can translate that line about y-axis, about x-axis. We can rotate that entity. we can enlarge that entity, we can reduce the size of that entity, we can perform the sharing operation. Means these are the various operations are performed there that we have to see in this unit. Then second part is their projections. So that is a part of engineering graphics, orthographic projection, isometric projection and perspective projection. Now by using again matrix method, we have to perform the orthographic projection, isometric projection and perspective projection. So here only theoretical part we have to study, no necessity of going for the problem. So there is a problems are also there on this orthographic projection, isometric projection and perspective projection. So this is the entire unit number one. 6 hours are provided for that. So totally this chapter is based on 90% numericals are there, and only this part is a theoretical part. Means if there is any short note is there in the question paper, so that will be based on this topic projection. Rest part or numerical will be there on this topic, that is nothing but 6 marks. Means if in same 10 mark is there, out of that one problem will be there on this topic for 10 marks. And if 6 marks and 4 marks theory will be there, 6 marks problem and 4 mark theory will be there. So theory will be on projections and numerical again based on this transformation. Okay, then here also maximum 3 vertices elements that are to be considered for 3D transformations. Okay, means for 2D transformation, what do you mean by 3 vertices? Means what? We can go up to triangle. Okay, triangle is formed by what? 3 vertices. For example, ABC triangle is there, so it will form by 3 vertices. Line is there, it is formed by 2 vertices or 2 endpoints. A point is there, it will form by a single vertex. Okay, means if we are going with the 3D transformation, then it will be for 3 vertices. Means there will be no problem on rectangle or square or hexagon, pentagon or hexagon. Okay, so in unit number 1 detailed we know what we have to perform. We have to, in unit number 1 we have to study geometry is given in the problem statement. We have to perform certain operations on that geometry using matrix multiplication methods. Okay, so that will be part of the computer graphics. Now why this is included in the computer graphics? Because what are the changes that we have to perform, that should be reflected on the screen, or that should be reflected somewhere. Means what? The matrix multiplication, that will be nothing but the change in the database. Apan kay karto hai, we are changing the database. Based on that, the various changes are done on graphical property, just like size and shape changes. It will change its position. Okay, it will rotated. So that changes should be reflected on screen. That's why we are included it in computer graphics. Okay, second chapter is a geometric modeling. Okay, geometric modeling is nothing but what? A modeling of a particular component or element. So in that important is curves. Means we have to study different types of curves. Now in graphics we know what are the types of curve. That is nothing but line, it is a one type of curve, circle, ellipse, parabola, hyperbola. These are the curves. Again, this is Hermit cubic spline curve, Bezier curve, B spline curve. These are what various types of curves are there that are there in what? Engineering graphics. But we have to represent that curve by analytical equations. How that curves are represented by analytical equation, that we have to study in this unit, geometric modeling, analytical curves. And second one is a synthetic curves. So numericals will be there on line, circle, ellipse, Hermit cubic spline curve and Bezier curve. Then also there is a surfaces. Means geometric modeling can be done using what? Curves, surfaces and solid. Means if you want to form a particular model, for that purpose what we have to do, we must know the knowledge of, or we must go with the modeling with the curves, surfaces and solids. Means first we have to define the curves, after that we have to define the surfaces, and after that we have to go for the solids. Okay, so in surfaces again there are different types of surfaces are there. Surface representation, analytical surfaces, synthetic surfaces, Hermite bicubic surfaces, Bezier surface, B-spline surfaces, means what are the curves are there? Again, that curves are converted into the surfaces. Then solids are there, topology, geometry and topology concept is there, boundary representation is there, Euler equation is there. Okay, so here surfaces and solids, there will be no problems on surface and solid topic, only theoretical treatment is there. And problems will be there on this topic, curves, means numerical will be there on line, circle, ellipse, parabola and hyperbola. Means for again in same, if 10 mark problem is there, then that will be based on this line, circle, ellipse or Hermite cubic curve. And if 6 mark problem and theory is there, then that will be based on surfaces and solid. Problem will be based on curves and theory will be based on surfaces and solids. Okay, so this is the content of unit number 2, that is nothing but geometric model. Okay, computer graphics, geometric modeling. Third is a finite element analysis, that is nothing but a using a different software or analytical method, how the analysis of a particular component is carried out, that we have to study in this unit, finite element analysis. In that introduction, means this unit number 3 is included in your second subject FEA, that is nothing but elective 1, finite element analysis. You have one unit in one subject is there in your syllabus, finite element analysis. So some part is there which is common for FEA subject as well as CAD/CAM subjects. So here we have to study different techniques for element analysis using a software as well as using a analytical method. So here two problems will be there, one dimensional problem and two dimensional problem. One dimensional problem means what? For example, if we consider a particular component, if in only one direction force is applied, then that problem or deformation is there, then that problem will be considered as a one dimensional problem. Second one is a trusses, two dimensional problem. So we can apply the loads in x direction as well as in the y direction, positive as well as negative. Okay, so that part we have to study in this unit number 3, finite element analysis. So theoretical part is also there, numerical part is also there. So composite shaft component is provided, or we have to perform the finite element analysis of the shaft. Spring element is there, in that series, if spring are connected in series and spring are connected in parallel, then we have to perform the operation. That is nothing but 1D problems. And 2D problems are there, so that will be based on the trusses. Truss element, you know the application of trusses, that is nothing but bridges, transmission towers are there, which are formed by a truss element. Means we have to perform the analysis of that 2D truss element. Okay, so numerical limited to 4 by 4 matrix. Means the problems based on the trusses will be there by 4 by 4 matrix maximum. Means if two matrices are there, the maximum limit will be 4 by 4. So there may be 2 by 2, 3 by 3 or 4 by 4 matrix multiplication is there. Means here again we have to take help of unit number 1. Here we perform the various transformation operations, same some knowledge we require here in unit number 3 for finite element analysis. Then we have unit number 4 as a computer aided manufacturing. Means unit number 1, unit number 2 and unit number 3 is a part of CAD, computer aided design. With the help of computer we can create, modify, analyze and optimize the things. So the CAD contents are included in unit number 1, 2 and 3. So after that our geometric model is ready, our CAD design is ready. Means 3 chapters we have to or which gives knowledge or which gives the information about CAD, computer aided design. Next, computer aided manufacturing means that is the extension of CAD. Computer aided manufacturing is nothing but we have to perform the manufacturing operations as per design, means the design done in the CAD. Okay, so computer aided manufacturing, this is a theoretical chapter as well as it include the programming part. Programmings means what? Two important part programmings are there. So before that, we must know the various information or theoretical part of the different manufacturing machines. Just like we must know the CNC lathe, turning center, milling centers, and steps in developing the CNC part program. Then tool and geometric compensation, CAN cycle, etc. Means what? On which machine we have to perform the operation, that knowledge we must know. Then programming, what type of programming is required for the manufacturing process, that knowledge we must know. Then what are the types of tool and geometric compensation, geometric properties we require, that we must know. Then different manufacturing cycles are there to save the time, to make the program simple. So this CAN cycle we have to study. Okay, so this is again theoretical part. Next one is the CNC lathe part programming and CNC milling part programming. What is meant by part programming? For example, simple part is provided, a cube is there, and we have to perform a particular operation on that cube. Means we have to form a drilling operation or hole on that cube. For that purpose, which type of programming is required? From where tool starts, from where tool end, or tool movement, etc. That will become under this linear and circular interpolation. Then different operation, that is nothing but facing operation, threading, grooving, etc. So here theory plus program is there. No problems are there in unit number 4. Theoretical part is there and program is there. Means what? One problem statement is given, part is given to you, and you have to form a program for different operation. Means if we are going with the manufacturing of lathe, manufacturing of component using lathe machine, so we must know the what are the different operations that can be performed on lathe machine. That is nothing but what? Facing operation, turning operation, groove operation, chamfer is there, fillet operation is there, threading operation is there. Means that operations we are going to perform on the lathe machine. For that purpose, we have to generate the program, and that program we have to give to the CNC computer. After that, it will form a particular manufacturing operation. Similarly, we have to go for the CNC milling. So if lathe machine is there, turning operations are there. Means if a cylindrical component is there, then we have to go for the lathe machine. If our component is a rectangular, or for that purpose we have to go with the CNC milling operation. So here we have a different operation, just like pocketing we have to perform, then drilling is there, countering is there, then removal of the material is there from outer side of the component. For that operations we have to perform on milling machine. So we have to perform the programming for that particular operations. So there are two methods of programming that we have to study in this unit number 4. That is nothing but one is a manual part programming, and second one is a part programming using a software. Manual part programming, that is a one method, and second method is a programming using a software. Means software gives you program, you have to just perform the operations. Okay, just like MasterCAM software is there, Bobcad software is there. So using that softwares we can perform the part program, and simply by using a drive, pen drive, or memory card, we can give that program to the CNC computer. Okay, then this is a entire chapter number 4, computer aided manufacturing. Means what? After generation of the model, how the component is get manufactured using a different machining operation. Means here prerequisites are given, What are prerequisites? Manufacturing processes. Means what? This knowledge is required for this chapter point of view. Okay. Manufacturing. Which type of machine we have to select for manufacturing. Next one is advanced manufacturing methods. Okay. This is part. Okay. In that we have to study product life cycle, PLM, then rapid prototyping technique. Okay. So SLA, LOM, SLS, FDM, 3D printing. These are the various methods of rapid prototyping. That concept you have to study in this chapter. So this chapter is total theoretical chapter. Okay. No numericals are there on unit number 5. Then unit number 6 is automation. Automation is required for what? To save the time, to increase the productivity, to reduce the cost of manufacturing, to improve the accuracy, less labor required, saving the manpower, etc. Okay, for that purpose we are going with the automation. So here types of automations are there. Then FMS, flexible manufacturing system, is there. Its advantages, limitations, etc. are there. Then second technique in automation is a group technology. Okay. Then third is a robotics. Okay. Definition of robot, laws of robotics, classification of robots, robot anatomy, then different path followed by the robots. Okay. Then grippers are there, types of grippers and applications. Means this automation chapter is also based on the theory. Okay. So here this is our 1 to 6 chapter for the syllabus. So numericals based, total numericals are there based on unit number 1. Numericals are there in unit number 2, geometric model, there also numericals. Okay. Unit number 3, there are numericals. Means unit number 1, unit number 2 and unit number 3 includes numerical and some theoretical part. Means 80% is numerical and 20% or very less amount of theoretical part is there in unit number 1, 2, 3. Then unit number 4, unit number 5 and unit number 6, there will be no numericals. Total theoretical part are there. Okay. Next, screen share. Do not share the screen. Okay. No need to share screen. Okay. So here books, reference book as well as textbook, that can be helpful for us for this subject. Oh, textbook first is a Zaid Ibrahim Zaid textbook. That is a very good book. Then second one is a Chandru Patla TR, which is used for study of third unit. That is nothing but FEA, finite element analysis. Then reference book Ibrahim Zaid is there, which is important book. Okay. So you can note down Ibrahim Zaid. Textbook Ibrahim Zaid, same. So 2 to 3 books are there which can be sufficient for syllabus or to cover the all the topics. CAD/CAM Theory and Practices, Tata McGraw Hill publication. Second, Chandru Patla TR. Then in reference book again Ibrahim Zaid, same book is there. The term of part will be there and practical, that will be seen later on. Now we will move towards our actual syllabus of starting from unit number 1, computer graphics. Unit number 1, computer graphics. So syllabus is already discussed with you. Transformations. Before that, we must have the knowledge of CAD. What do you mean by CAD? Okay. So CAD is nothing but what? It is the use of computers or workstation to aid in the creation, modification, analysis or optimization of the design. Now, CAD is nothing but simply it is the use of the computer system for modeling purpose or for designing purpose. So here steps are given as we can create something by using a computer, we can modify, we can analyze, and we can optimize. So this is a simple definition of CAD. It is the use of computers or workstations to aid in the, or it guides the user for the creation, modification, analysis, or optimization of a design. So using computer, we have to perform the design. Second one is the computer graphics. What is meant by computer graphics? Now, computer graphics, it is an art of drawing pictures on computer screen with the help of programming. Okay. Now you know each and every computer have a graphics card or laptop. If you have a laptop, then it has a graphics card. That is nothing but it is a part of visualization of the pictures on your screen. So computer graphics is nothing but what? It is a art of drawing pictures on computer screen with the help of programming. Now what that programming involves? It involves computation, creation, manipulation of the data. What do you mean by computation, creation, and manipulation of the data? Means as per our requirement, as per our convenience, we can make the necessary changes. Okay. So in other words, computer graphics is a tool for generation and manipulation of images. Means if you have one original image, we can generate or we can manipulate that image by simply changing the database. That is called as a computer graphics. Means if we change the database, automatically on computer screen it changes its graphical properties, called as a manipulation. Next one, to display a picture of any size on a computer screen is a difficult process. Hey, aplyala maiti aahe barobar. Computer graphics are used to simplify this process. Means what? If a big size, if any complex picture is there or any size picture is there which can be, which cannot display, or if it is very difficult to display by using a computer screen, computer graphics are used to simplify this process. So various algorithms are there and techniques are there which can be used to generate the graphics in computer. Then what is the main advantage of computer graphics? It is the ability of computers to store the complex drawing and display them whenever needed. Computer graphics is the major advantage of computer graphics is what? It can store the complex drawing of any object or any geometry or any model, and it can easily display whenever it is needed. Next part is the what? Transformations. 2D and 3D transformation. Now what is meant by transformation? Transformation means changing some graphics into something else by applying rule. Means by using some rules, we have to change the some graphical nature of any particular entity or geometry. That is called as a transformations. So various types of transformations are there, like translation is there, scaling is there, up and down is there, rotation is there, shearing is there. Now when a transformation takes place on 2D plane, it is called as a 2D transformation. Means in XY coordinate system, if we perform the various operation, then it will be called as a 2D transformation. If we perform the various operations with respect to 3 axis coordinate system XYZ, then it is called as a 3D transformation. Now what is the role or of transformation in computer graphics? It is the reposition of the graphics on the screen and change their size and orientation. Now we have to go for the two dimensional geometric transformation. Transformation is nothing but we have to perform a certain operation, and geometric transformation is nothing but we have to perform the that operations on a particular geometry. Now geometry is what? Geometry is formed by various elements or various coordinates or various vertices. For example, line is a geometry, or which is one type of element which is formed by two endpoints. So that will be considered as a geometry. And if that geometry we represent in a XY coordinate system, means P1 and P2 are the two points, X1, Y1 are the coordinates of P1, X2, Y2 are the coordinates of P2, and that line can be represented in XY coordinate system called as a 2D geometric. Barabar. Then, what is the definition of geometric transformation? Geometric transformation can be defined as the change done to the database by performing certain mathematical operation on it. Means what? We have a geometry, it has a certain database, means it has its coordinates or vertices or properties. Then we have to perform a certain mathematical operation so that to produce the desired change in the image. Means in XY coordinate system, for example, if triangle is given, it is formed by a three coordinates ABC, means it will be X1, Y1, X2, Y2 and X3, Y3. Now the coordinates are nothing but a original database of that particular geometry. Now I want to perform the geometric transformation operation on that original triangle. Means I want to enlarge that triangle, I want to reduce that triangle, I want to translate that triangle or move that triangle with respect to x axis, or move that triangle with respect to y axis. Okay, or I have to rotate that triangle about origin, about a particular point. Barabar. So for that purpose, I want to perform a certain mathematical operations. Okay, so that the desired change can be made in the image. Means what? Now that can be done using a geometric transformation. Tell us upon, or it is called as a geometric transformation. And if that transformation is with respect to x and y coordinate, then it will be 2D geometric transformation. If that transformation is with respect to x, y, z coordinate system, then it will be called as a 3D transformation. In our syllabus, 3D transformation is limited. We have to focus on the 2D geometric transformation. Now, what are the application or use of geometric transformation? For what purpose geometric transformation can be used? That we have to see. First, creating models and view of models. Means by using 2D geometric transformation, we can create the models and we can view the model on computer screen. Then to express the location of object relative to each other. By using geometric transformation, we can express the location of object relative to each other like this. So these are the two objects. By using the base point, we can locate the object with respect to each other. That is also application of geometric transformation. Means what? Initially, this is element number one or part number one. This is part number two. Now, what I want to perform the operation? I want to place this job number two on this job number one and with respect to these two base point. So for that purpose, what I want to perform? I have to move this part two from position to this original position to this position. So after the transformation operation, it will be look like this. Means we can express the location of the object for using the geometric transformation. Next important part is what, or the second advantage or third advantage of geometric transformation? It is used to view the object from different positions and direction. Means using geometric transformations, we can view the objects from different position as well as different directions. Then geometric transformation can be used to perform the transformations like translation, rotation, scaling and mirror. Means these are the operations that we have to perform using a geometric transformation. Next, it is geometric transformations can be used to obtain the orthographic as well as perspective view of the model. That is also an important advantage or use of the geometric transformation. Next one, geometric transformation can be used to perform the kinematic analysis of for making the animations of the models. Means these are the six important advantages or use of the geometric transformation technique. By using geometric transformation operations, we can create the model, view the models. We can express the location of object relative to each other using geometric transformations. We can view the objects from different position and direction. Then we can perform the operations like translation, rotation, scaling, mirror, etc. Then we can obtain the various orthographic, isometric as well as the perspective view of the model. And it can perform the kinematic analysis for making the animations of the model. So this is just introductory part of CAD as well as computer graphics. So in next lecture, we will start with the actual formulation. That is nothing but how the line or any geometry is represented in XY coordinate system. After that, how the matrix is formed for a particular geometry, if point is there, how point is represented by using a matrix, if line is there, how line is represented by using the matrix. Okay, so for today's session, this much is sufficient, syllabus part and introduction of unit number 1. So tomorrow or in next session, we will again going forward for next as per our syllabus.